Gildan Media, a division of Recorded Books, presents Authentic Marketing, How to Capture Hearts and Minds Through the Power of Purpose, by Larry Weber. Narrated by Jordan Ahnquist. Forward. For the past 15 years, I have had the pleasure of running companies that specialize in leadership networks and professional networking, giving me the unique opportunity to meet literally hundreds of Fortune 500 executives. I've had the privilege to hear firsthand their aspirations, fears, leadership philosophies, and challenges in an era that is unprecedented in its speed and scale, where technology has upended the way we interact, buy, operate, and sell. Through this experience, it has become clear that companies and leaders are in a furious race to stay relevant, and it is no longer good enough to just make money. Operating with ethics, making judgment calls with a social conscience, and staying authentically relevant are critical for survival in business today. Yielding more than increased sales and shareholder wealth is now a key element of that imperative. Fast forward to the present, where I am now in the thriving hub of Cambridge, Massachusetts, with the amazing opportunity of serving as CEO of Reputation Institute, the data-driven reputation advisory firm. In this new role, I was invited to chat with one of the legends of the universe of PR and brand management, Larry Weber, to exchange ideas on the need for companies to infuse a sense of purpose into the soul of their organization. It was a very intriguing and timely discussion, given that we are embarking into an era of corporate mistrust, where consumers are crying out for companies to take the lead in doing good for the world while also delivering on their goods and services. As the leading company in the domain of mining, measuring, and managing reputation, and as a purveyor of reputation intelligence, Reputation Institute has a deep understanding and expertise in this realm. As we were having our exploratory conversations, Larry was deep into the throes of writing Authentic Marketing, How to Capture Hearts and Minds Through the Power of Purpose. This is his sixth book, and it offers listeners the opportunity to discover the critical role of moral purpose for companies and to better understand the need to integrate core competencies, business operations, technology, and engagement strategies around that purpose. What struck me in our discussions about the book and the topic of using purpose as a central guiding principle for companies was the inspiring and fluid way in which Larry engages with concepts of ethics, morality, integrity, and purpose. He feels it, knows it, and sees the gaps that marketers, brand owners, and C-suite executives need to fill to embrace it. It is no longer a world where the purpose of a company is merely rhetoric or represented by a poster of platitudes with no sense of direction, alignment, or commitment to deliver on it. Larry has seen with clarity the inspiring movie in 3D vision, where companies use purpose effectively to elevate their brands, stakeholder engagement, and long-term value to new levels. But he has also witnessed the flip side when companies don't. His book encapsulates those experience-driven insights that help organizations discover the intersection of profit and purpose. The subject of using purpose to drive decision-making is key to companies and their leadership teams and has become a strategic imperative in remaining relevant for future employees, customers, investors, and influencers. Staying relevant means keeping up with trends, adapting to new environments, and constantly reinventing your business by taking mental shortcuts to act upon large amounts of information and embrace new ways of thinking. For leaders, marketing and brand professionals, and their colleagues, infusing purpose into the soul of your business is an inspirational raison d'etre that should guide decision-making, drive actions, and motivate companies to rethink how they tell their stories, the channels through which they deliver them, and the way they use data and technology to do so. Larry guides the listener to think about the potential revenue impact of a successfully demonstrated commitment to purpose and highlights the importance of storytelling and visual expression that is relevant for the world we live in today. Larry brings a wealth of knowledge, connections, and foresight to the topic of purpose. He has the trust of global clients who have shared their stories with him and the undisputed wisdom as someone who has been at the frontier of building brand and marketing ecosystems for years. As a leader, he has not only proven his own ability to help clients stay relevant with his firm's focus on technology, but also has a track record of predicting those trends that define the future. Kylie Wright Ford, CEO, Reputation Institute. Introduction. Almost 40 years ago, I began a career in marketing, not knowing where it would take me. Today, the answer is clear. Authentic marketing is the result of a series of evolutionary changes brought about by digital communications, social media, and the internet, along with a generational mandate that companies operate with strong values, more humanity, and a moral purpose to do good for the world. Companies today have an unprecedented opportunity to transform their businesses around a purpose that is a true extension of their DNA. It's the intersection of where profit meets purpose and the essence of doing well by doing good. As they discover a new foundation in moral purpose, their stories will be told and shared in a powerful light with transparency and impact, which is the heart of authentic marketing. Through this, they'll experience deeper and more meaningful engagement with customers, as well as attract a workforce motivated by purpose. Most importantly, they'll find these efforts will not only enhance their long-term value, but also make a difference in the world, which is the answer to society's ask. I sincerely hope companies everywhere will embrace this change and we collectively can reinvent good around the world. Larry Weber, Boston, Massachusetts. Part 1. Authentic Marketing and the Power of Purpose. Chapter 1. Profit Meets Purpose. Find Your Company's Soul. Every so often, the business world awakens to a new reality. We are in the midst of one today that directly addresses a question keeping most CEOs up at night. How do I deliver long-term sustainable value that motivates employees, engages customers, strengthens my brand, and delivers the profitability my stakeholders demand? The answer is simple, yet transformative. As we move through the 21st century, companies need to find their moral purpose, something that lives within the soul of their business, which can translate into a form of good that is beneficial to both their bottom line and to mankind. Profit meets purpose, the clarion call of today. Companies rising to answer this call are well-positioned to become the iconic brands that define this era, which has moved beyond digital to one of social consciousness. Proof of this profound shift came from a surprising call to action from BlackRock CEO Lawrence Fink in his 2018 annual letter to CEOs, which sent shockwaves through the financial community. Society is demanding that companies, both public and private, serve a social purpose. To prosper over time, every company must not only deliver financial performance, but also show how it makes a positive contribution to society. Without a sense of purpose, no company, either public or private, can achieve its full potential. It will ultimately lose the license to operate from stakeholders. Lawrence Fink, BlackRock CEO. As the head of a firm that manages more than $6 trillion in investments, this influential investor is completely changing the dialogue and, in the process, sounding the alarm to the C-suite. It may be a watershed moment on Wall Street, one that raises all sorts of questions about the very nature of capitalism. But for the world's largest investor to say it out loud and declare that he plans to hold companies accountable is a bracing example of the evolution of corporate America, said New York Times columnist Andrew Ross Sorkin. He added that Fink's argument, in part, rests on the changing mood of the country regarding social responsibility. Proving that point are findings from an April 5, 2018 Covestro survey of U.S. Fortune 1000 CEOs on business and purpose. The survey found that 69% of senior executives say the act of balancing profit and purpose is having a positive, transformational impact on business, with half or more reporting such impacts as they integrate a purpose-driven approach into various functions. 4 out of 5, 80%, agree that a company's future growth and success will hinge on a values-driven mission that balances profit and purpose. And 75% believe these types of companies will have a competitive advantage over those that do not. Beyond CSR. What we're talking about here is a reinvented good, which is markedly different from simply implementing a traditional CSR effort, typically a siloed initiative that is completely separate from a company's business focus, product development, marketing, etc. By contrast, this better good is central to the organization's core mission. It is a fundamental value that is infused into the company's bloodstream so that it runs horizontally through every facet of the business, from R&D and marketing to finance and HR. Discovering a moral mission requires a little soul searching. Typically, it involves an exercise that serves to identify an intrinsic value embedded in a company's DNA, which is a logical extension of the business that can do good for the world. The end of this chapter provides an exercise on this process, but I'll offer the example here to help bring it to life. A few years back, I asked Sam Allen, chairman and CEO Deere & Company, what he wanted his legacy to be at his venerable company, which has been in operation since 1837. His answer was not to simply sell more green tractors than the previous CEO. His vision was to, yes, continue to have Deere deliver profitability to stakeholders by selling plenty of those machines, but moreover, to elevate the brand by delivering a higher value to its customers and the world. The strategy, which moved Deere into an entirely different category than its competitors, was to use software to enable farmers to maximize their yield, ultimately helping them feed an ever-growing planet. With the population expected to grow by 2 billion, this enabled Deere to address a major world issue. This was Deere's moral purpose. This purposeful moral path is analogous to Aristotle's eudaimonia, a Greek word that often is translated to mean the state of having a good indwelling spirit. Aristotle's concept was that a man who possesses excellence or virtue in character does the right thing at the right time and in the right way. Similarly, companies that follow this path of right will prosper on multiple levels, as it will fuel business prosperity and deliver an entirely new level of engagement with stakeholders. Deloitte sets an excellent example of a large global network that is embracing this new form of good. I spoke with Diana O'Brien, Deloitte Global Chief Marketing Officer, about the company's robust, world-class 50 Million Futures Initiative, which is focused on empowering millions who have been left behind to succeed through education and training. What makes Deloitte unique is the belief that we're really only as good as the good we do. We empower our more than 260,000 people around the network to go out and make an impact that matters for clients, people, and communities. Professionals are asked to share their core skills and experience to reach the goal of preparing 50 million futures for a world of opportunity. That's the rallying cry. It's accessible, available to everyone, and understood around the globe. Authentic marketing, the driver of true engagement. What excites me most about this infusion of good into business strategy is that it creates a natural byproduct of authentic marketing, the most powerful form of marketing I have witnessed in my entire career. Digital media and the internet put us on this journey toward a more genuine form of marketing. These disruptive forces indelibly changed marketing from a one-way shout-it-to-the-masses, no-listening environment to a dialogue-driven, engagement-centric approach that put the power in the hands of consumers, where it belongs. The addition of moral purpose is the essential missing piece in this equation, the tipping point, if you will, that forges entirely new levels of engagement between companies and constituents. Companies doing this new, deeper good will experience marketing that is far more transparent and organic, as it will be largely done at the hands of constituents who are eager to share positive stories across social channels. In this sense, they will serve to co-create companies' brands. It unleashes the true power of earned, social and traditional, media, the most important media in my opinion, and also serves up powerful narratives for owned and paid media. Most importantly, it helps companies establish trust with constituents, the fundamental component of engagement and brand loyalty. Chapter 4 provides the essential skills of an authentic marketing program. Good momentum. Look around, and you'll see this form of good is starting to take hold across all industries, from agriculture to automotive, and all around the world, from Beijing to Bangladesh. Fortune, for example, has been covering this business phenomenon for the past 3 years in its Change the World list, with help from its partners at Shared Value Initiative, profiling more than 50 companies around the globe that are doing well by doing good. These organizations use a profit model to solve a host of global problems, from climate change to world hunger. Companies are chosen based on three criteria. 1. Measurable social impact on special societal problems. 2. Business results of profitability and contribution to shareholder value. And 3. Degree of innovation in its efforts and whether others are following the lead. Among the companies in Fortune's September 2017 list is Unilever, the $30 billion Anglo-Dutch consumer products giant. The article highlights that what CEO Paul Polman is most excited about is the 1.8 million people who apply for a job there each year, many of whom are millennials. What's the appeal? You guessed it. Unilever's sustainable living plan and its bigger purpose as a business are the primary draws among roughly 60% of applicants who feel it gives them an opportunity to make a bigger difference in the world than they could do on their own. This example highlights another critical outcome of having a social purpose. It has strong appeal to not only the population in general, but millennials in particular. An audience more than 80 million strong that accounts for an estimated $1 trillion of current U.S. consumer spending, according to an article in the Huffington Post. The article also notes that 73% of this generation is willing to pay extra for sustainable offerings. Moreover, a full 81% expect companies to make public declarations of their corporate citizenship. Covestro's survey on business and purpose found that 77% of new hires and 76% of current employees are the primary drivers of demand for purpose-driven companies, followed by customers. A full 86% of CEOs, C-suite executives, confirmed that today's top talent is more inclined to work for companies with a demonstrated commitment to social issues compared to ones that don't. This underscores that doing good is no longer a nice extra, but an essential action that is expected of every company in every industry. One of the new requirements to attract top talent. Another standout name on Fortune's Change the World list is the nation's largest retailer, Walmart. According to Fortune, the company is using its muscle to make its supply chain greener by pushing its tens of thousands of suppliers to gradually get rid of controversial chemicals like formaldehyde in wood resin-based products in about 90,000 household items. This effort is an extension of the retailer's longer-term sustainability campaign. The company has diverted 82% of materials that used to be considered waste away from landfills, compared with 64% just a few years ago. IBM. Legacy values working for good. Technology giant IBM was also spotlighted on Fortune's list for its stellar efforts to close the STEM skills gap in public schools, addressing the shortage of highly skilled employees in America. Recently, I had a fascinating interview with John Iwata, IBM Senior Vice President and Chief Brand Officer, who currently chairs the company's newly created Values and Policy Advisory Board, which recommends policies and principles for IBM. Iwata frames our conversation on IBM's societal purpose by going back to the very early days of the company, demonstrating its deep roots of following a strong value system. The company was founded on fundamental beliefs which can be traced back to Thomas Watson Sr., who became IBM's first CEO in 1914. Like Steve Jobs, Richard Branson, and Phil Knight of today, Watson had deep beliefs about IBM's purpose and what it should stand for. He institutionalized those as the company's basic beliefs. Although that phrase has since passed out of our vocabulary for various reasons, the idea remains that our company is set apart by what it believes and stands for. For example, IBM's long-standing commitment to what most recognize as diversity and inclusion today goes back to the company's belief in respect for the individual. That has always meant that we see an individual not as a man or a woman. We don't see an individual based on race, ethnicity, or disability, and therefore, we demonstrate respect for each individual and work to help each person fulfill his, her potential in society and in IBM. We're proud that IBM was the first major company to hire a disabled employee and the first to promote a woman to vice president. The idea that new technology creates societal implications is not new. For example, technology will always have an impact on jobs. Some occupations go away. Typing pools have gone away, as have human computers. However, entirely new occupations and jobs get created. 50 years ago, were there coders and software engineers, cybersecurity analysts, even CIOs? IBM has felt a responsibility to not only create new technology, but to also ensure that the new technology is adopted and applied in ways that earn trust. Helping people develop new skills is part of that. Today, we're doing it again with AI, what we call new-collar jobs. Our view is not to say, don't worry about the jobs that go away. It's to understand requirements of the new jobs and the new requirements of existing jobs, which are often overlooked. Moreover, it's to take the additional step of creating curriculums, of engaging educational institutions, whether it's MIT or a high school in New York City, to create the new curriculum and teach new skills so that workers, young future workers like kids or existing workers, can move to the new. We don't have to do that. We choose to do that. Is it the right thing to do? It's the right thing for IBM because we've always felt we do not just stop by creating the new technology. We go the additional step of anticipating and then addressing it so that we can have a positive impact. Patagonia, pioneering sustainability. The term sustainability is almost synonymous with Patagonia. A true pioneer with a fierce dedication for the past 40 years to lead the clothing industry in the adoption of sustainable processes. On the company's website, you'll see its moral purpose embedded throughout every aspect of its business and articulated loud and clear in its mission. Build the best product, cause no unnecessary harm, use business to inspire and implement solutions to the environmental crisis. Its latest initiative, Patagonia Action Works, is an environmental activist effort to get supporters more involved in politics. As an outdoor gear retailer, Patagonia is an obvious fit for doing good for the world. But any brand in any industry can and should find its moral purpose. Smaller companies are popping up all over that are launched with a moral mission. For example, on a recent trip to London, I walked into a store called Gandhi's. As soon as I entered, the salesperson told me the story of the brand, a business created by two siblings who, while traveling the world with their parents, sadly lost them during the tsunami in Sri Lanka. These orphan siblings later formed Gandhi's in honor of their parents and to support their Orphans for Orphans Foundation, which helps underprivileged children affected by the tsunami. The salesperson told this moving story before she mentioned the current sale or anything about the merchandise, because it was, first and foremost, what the brand was all about. Guess how we reacted? We all wanted to buy a t-shirt, backpack, or sweater to support its mission. The call for action-driven businesses. So why this and why now? It's simple. The world needs more good. People can no longer rely on government to solve some of the planet's thorniest problems, like world hunger, climate change, public health issues, and poverty. The list goes on. Yet, our planet has more complex problems than ever before. Because of that, people are looking to the private sector to step up, take action, and address issues that matter most to them. This is the thrust of Fink's message to CEOs. Many companies are doing this, some in unexpected ways. One example that stunned the business community and struck a nerve in the healthcare arena was the January 30th, 2018 announcement that Amazon, Berkshire Hathaway, and J.P. Morgan Chase & Company are partnering to form an independent healthcare company for their U.S. employees. This new organization is being formed to address a pressing issue in healthcare: helping people find simplified, high-quality, and transparent healthcare at a reasonable cost, according to the press release. This unprecedented move illustrates how companies are moving into non-traditional territory, taking on bold new initiatives to address frustrating problems that are a top priority. Another example is a company taking action following the devastating Parkland, Florida shooting in February 2018. Dick's Sporting Goods was among several companies that took an anti-gun stance and changed its policies. The company announced it would stop selling assault-style rifles and high-capacity magazines and pushed for gun control measures in Congress. The stock market showed its approval, with shares closing up. A new strategy model for a new era. For purpose to be a great transformer in any organization, it requires not just new thinking, but an entirely retooled business model involving a broader definition of strategy. Chapter 3 outlines the elements of this tightly integrated model. This model will disrupt the highly siloed approach, in which a company develops a business strategy first, and then separate strategies for all other departments, an approach that has been in existence for decades. The new strategy fuses a tight integration across all of these critical pillars of business with purpose as the glue that binds them. While the concept of purpose is in vogue right now, this is by no means a flash-in-the-pan trend. I believe this is a core strategic driver that will become a permanent element of business strategy. Simply put, it is now an ethical responsibility for companies to integrate good into their overall strategies. Soul searching. Exercise to find your moral DNA. In my work to help companies identify their moral purpose, I've found that people have very different reactions. For some, an obvious answer will surface immediately. For others, the concept feels overwhelming. In both cases, the exercise outlined here will provide clarity. If you think you have a great idea, this process will serve as a reality check. If you aren't sure how to start, it will put you on the path of discovery. Key to this process is remembering this: the purpose you identify should be a natural and logical extension of your business, something embedded in the DNA of your organization. I bring this up again because when this purpose is truly at the heart of your company and its values, something that's a natural fit, it will take hold, have staying power, and deliver as it should, impacting both the success of your business and of your mission to do good. I'll give a few examples to provide context and ignite your thinking. A company that developed drones, for example, might find a way to put those mini aircrafts to work for disaster relief. A pharmaceutical company that develops drugs to help people with diabetes could fund research to help find a cure or shed light on new nutrition strategies. A business that develops steel might work to find a cleaner, more sustainable manufacturing process. I've yet to work with an organization that could not find a moral purpose that was a natural extension of its business. In most cases, it's an intuitive answer. The process is actually quite straightforward and involves asking a series of questions around key topics: your company, legacy and values, your audience, your offerings, and pressing issues associated with your business, products, or services. Your moral mission will be born out of integrating the answers. Step 1. Explore values. Start by looking at your company.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.